time that America refused to give the Negro any land. Through an act of Congress, our government was giving away millions of acres of land in the West and the Midwest, which meant that it was willing to undergird its white peasants from Europe with an economic floor. But not only did they give the land, they built land-grant colleges with government money to teach them how to farm. Not only that, they provided county agents to further their expertise in farming. Not only that, they provided low interest rates in order that they could mechanize their farms. Not only that, today many of these people are receiving millions of dollars in federal subsidies not to farm, and they are the very people telling the black man that he ought to lift himself by his own bootstraps. Now, this is what we are faced with, and this is a reality. Now, when we come to Washington in this campaign, we are coming to get our check.
This is why he said it's time to get our check. This is the first half of Dr. King's I Have a Dream speech. Everybody knows about the second half, about, you know, he wants all the little white boys, little white girls, little black boys and little black girls to come together hand in hand and, you know, judge everybody by their character. That's fine. But this is what he said. He set the record straight. Y'all read this for yourself. I'm just gonna read this underlying part. It says, 100 years later, the Negro is still languished in the corners of America's society and finds himself exiled in his own land. In exile in his own land. We are the Aborigine. So-called black people of America are really the copper-colored people of America. We are the American Indians. Get it right.